Hi, my name's Joanna Weaver, and I'm the author of Having a Merry Heart in a Martha World. And it's my privilege and honor to invite you to this year's Bible reading challenge called My Utmost for His Highest. Just like last year, we're going to read one chapter a day. We're going to read slowly, really meditating and thinking about what the Lord is speaking to us. And then we're going to respond in our journals and write that down. It's been so fun as over at my personal Facebook page, people have returned to the daily assignment thread and shared what God had taught them. And so it's been really, really rich as we've learned together. But this year, along with that single chapter a day, we're adding a devotional entry. It's an entry from a devotion that has literally traveled with me all of my adult Christian life. I've returned to its pages over and over through the years. And I'll tell you what, Oswald Chambers, My Utmost for His Highest. God has used this book in mighty, mighty ways. You can see how well loved it is. It was given to me by my pastor's wife, Terry Myers, and I'm going to cry when I talk about this because Terry was my mentor as a young associate's wife, a dear, dear friend, and she gave me this book, and I had no idea that actually Oswald Chambers would become one of my most treasured mentors as well. I know some people say, why add a devotional? You know, we should just read the Bible. That's all we need. And while, of course, the Bible is our utmost guide, it's the most important thing that we get into its pages and that God's Word gets into us. That's why we're reading slow and so reading less so we can reflect more. But, you know, as I was thinking about that, you know, even as writing books and you wonder why? I mean, really, Lord, are books needed? And sometimes, you know, people say, I only read the Bible, and I understand that, and that's beautiful. But you know what? God has used books in my life in elemental ways, especially those books that illuminate God's Word to me and takes pieces of God's words and really brings it to a practical level. And so as I was thinking about this and about adding a devotional, the Lord brought to mind those beautiful verses in Romans 10:14, where Paul writes, how then can they call on the one they have not believed in? And how can they believe in the one of whom they have not heard? And how can they hear without someone preaching to them? And all of a sudden, as I read those words, I began to realize, you know what? Christian books are so important. Devotionals are so important because it's almost like a sermon that while we've gone to the Word of God for ourselves and we're looking at it daily for God's truth for us, we're also reading a little sermon each day. And I'll tell you what, the entries are very short. They're less than a page or no more than a page. And they're so powerful. Now, I got to be honest, Oswald's language, this was written back in 1930s. And so the language is a little bit dated, but I love the classic. There's something so poetic about his writing and even some of the turns of phrases. I have to think about it, but then they really become alive to me. So I would encourage you, if you are already in love with Oswald Chambers, you stick with the classic. But if perhaps you've tried to read My Utmost for His Highest in the past and it's just been hard to understand, or perhaps you're new to it, I'd really encourage you to pick up the updated language edition. What I'm happy about is it doesn't change the meaning. It's not a paraphrase of My Utmost for His Highest. It just takes those turns of phrases that maybe don't make sense or some of the terminology that is a little bit hard to understand, and it freshens it up for us. And so I'm actually enjoying reading the updated version. So two choices that way. I'm really excited because we once again have created a Bible reading journal for you. This is free for signing up for my email list, and it includes some instructions on how the whole challenge works. Some tips for reading and marking your Bible. I'm really excited about Pray Every Day bonus pages that give you a space to put your prayer list all in your journal as well. Then it has the Bible reading schedule where it shows you what portions we're going to be doing each day. And then, of course, as always, we've got lined spaces. Can you see that? Lined spaces that have room for your Bible reading and then also room for your My Utmost reading and how it impressed you. Now listen, you don't have to do the devotional reading. You might just only want to do the Bible reading. But one way or another, we'd love to have you join us. So I hope that you'll sign up in that little box that says get your free journal. It's going to be a wonderful time together. And then be sure to follow me at facebook.com/joanna.weaver.9. We host it at my personal page, and it's a wonderful time of fellowship. I hope that explains a little bit more about the program. If you have any questions, feel free to leave it in the blog comments below. God bless.